Hello, my name is rayodaniel and welcome to my channel. In this video, we're going to continue our series on high-level features. This particular video, we're going to be covering the CRM component of Highlevel, what it is, how it works, and kind of go in depth about some of the features and things that you can do with it. Before we get started though, I would like to just see if you can please click subscribe, hit the like button on this video. It really does help me promote this channel. And also, if you find the video useful, if you do want to move forward and sign up for Highlevel, please feel free to use my affiliate link below. I do get credit for it. It would really help me out and I appreciate it. So let's get started. Hey, welcome back. Here you'll see that we're inside of Highlevel and we're already inside of a business account. This is a dummy account I've set up for demonstration purposes like this video. So inside of Highlevel, the CRM component is the contacts area located right here on the menu. So you see here we have, I've preloaded lots of different contacts in here for us to be able to deal with. And I'll show you how to do importing and exporting of that here in a little bit. But right now, one of the things I really want to start with is just to open up a contact and start showing you some of the features that you have inside of the contact field. So obviously there's out of the box, default contacts like first name, last name, email, date of birth, things like that. And one of the things I want you to pay attention to is these other two different areas of the contact field, general info, which already has some additional fields in it. And it also has an area for additional info. Notice that there are no fields in here. But one of the nice things about Highlevel that we're going to discuss in this video is how we can add different videos. Add different fields to this area of the contact record. So in a sense, you can add any custom fields that you want to keep track of. So we'll show you how to do that as well. Here we have any tags. It shows you any kind of campaigns or workflows that this particular user is actively involved with or ones that have been run in the past. If you're running pipelines and opportunities, this right here can show you the status of where they're at in the opportunity, as well as any products or offerings that they've made or if they've purchased from you. Here in this particular company field, you see that you can keep track of any particular company that that person belongs to, so you can keep track of that field. Here we don't have that listed, but all of the fields are accounted for. And here you see inside of the conversations area, this white area right here, all of the communication that you would have with this particular customer, whether it be through SMS, email, or any other mechanism, whether it be Facebook Messenger or Google My Business, any of those conversations are all maintained right here in this particular area of the contact record. Some of the other things I'd like to go over are the toolbar. Here's some of the things that you can do once you have records inside there. Number one, you can manually add a contact manually. You just simply click on this, open it up and fill all the fields out. Again, you can simply add it manually. Here we can select a few people and we can actually click here and change the pipeline of where they're in. If you deal with pipelines, you can simply add them or change from one stage to another on their pipelines. You can click here and add them to an email or workflow. Again, you have a variety of different things you can do here from sending an SMS or an email, adding tags, removing tags. All of this stuff can be done through here, deleting contacts, even your reputation management. If you wanted to select this and send these people a review of your business, just simply click on there, send them a review, and you can send them either a text or an email review from there. Here's some of the big things that I really like that CRM systems have are import and export features. So you're not limited to just having all of your data in here. You can get it in and get it out very quickly. Now, exporting contacts, you can just simply select whatever contacts you want, click on export, and just follow the export contacts. Here's your fields down here in the bottom. Pretty straightforward. Goes out into a CSV file. You can import that wherever you want. The biggest thing I wanted to show you is this nice feature here. Now, most businesses have a lot of contacts. They have a large CRM system, customers that they've dealt with in the past. But right now, how do you get information into to Highlevel? That's a big one. Not only that is, how do I deal with it and not have duplicate contacts? That's, again, the biggest problem is when I import stuff, how can I not have five of the same contact, knowing which trying to figure out which one I'm talking to. So under import contacts, I'm just going to show you this. I've already imported contacts. So we're going to go all the way up to the point of adding them before we stop on this one. But here, I'm going to just show you that I've got a customer file here that we're going to load. We're going to simply click on next. And this does have to be a CSV file. Once you upload this, notice that the column headers from the file, as long as they're named very appropriately, first name, last name, company field, the wizard can figure out which field maps to what field inside of Highlevel. Notice over here, you can take the zip code, it maps to postal code. So this check mark right here says that everything is matched, which means everything is going to go into the appropriate field. You just need to make sure that the phone number here goes to the phone number, email goes to the email field so that it goes into the right field. So you're going to go ahead and click on next. One of the other features that you've got here that's really awesome is this feature right here. So you can say add new or update existing contact record. Now, what Highlevel does is it actually uses an email address and a phone number field as some of the primary contacts for primary pieces of information with regards to a contact. So if it sees somebody with the same email or the same phone number, rather than duplicate that contact, it's just going to update, take the information and update the existing record. So this prevents all of the duplicate contacts. So in case you have 10 John Smiths that you deal with, but all the John Smiths have a different email address or phone number, then those records are maintained appropriately because it looks for the phone number and email address to match them. So once you do this, you can simply click submit. I'm not going to do that here because I don't want to duplicate the contacts that I've already got. But you click on that. It takes a few minutes for the engine to run, import, and now you have all of your contacts listed here. So inside this field, we're going to look at the more filters area. More filters, again, just as a nice way to sit back and segment, find particular people in your list and be able to identify them quickly. So right now, what we're going to do is we're going to simply click on first name. And we're going to pick somebody that we obviously see. We're going to just do Cassandra. So right now, we're going to just simply search for that. And notice there's only one person named Cassandra. So what we're going to do here is we're going to use this filter. And what we're going to do is I'm going to show you the Smartlists feature. Now, the Smartlists is a way of having predetermined filters already built inside of your CRM system. Now, we've already searched for Cassandra. So right now, I'm going to save this list. And I'm going to call it people named Cassandra. So I'm going to save this particular list. Now, notice up here in the top, I have an all list that shows me all of the contacts that I've got here. Now I've got people named Cassandra. Now this could be people in Oklahoma City, Oklahoma, for instance. It could be any list that you want to create, but now you can simply create a link of everybody up in here. Typically, I've used this in the past to indicate new customers. So if somebody is a lead, and whenever the system brings them in, if they get tagged as a lead, well, then I can simply go here and say, give me everybody who's tagged as a lead. And now I can click on this quickly and find everybody in my system that is currently a lead that is not a customer, for example. So this smart list is a really good way to segment your list and be able to quickly have your team go through it and find those particular people that you're looking for. So you don't have to do the same repetitive search over and over again. Now, one of the super cool features that I want to go over here is regarding the data of contacts. So if we looked in here, notice I said earlier that this additional info field, there's nothing in here. So right now, let's just say you're a company and you want to be able to keep track of, let's just say, anniversary date. I'm just picking something here. You can actually go into the settings of Highlevel, come over here to the custom fields area, and we can add a custom field. Now, you have to add what type of field this is. So anniversary date is going to be a date. So we're going to just choose date picker here. Now, if it was just a piece of information, a text, or multiple lines of text, or phone number, you can just simply add all of these right here, whatever you want. But you have to pick the type of data that you want. But right now, we're going to choose date picker. And we're going to sit back and give it a field name and just do anniversary date. Notice that this is regarding the contacts and right now what group that we want to add this in. So here we see contact to see it on the main contact screen. the general info. So if we do this, it'll be in the general info area. I'm going to add this into the additional info area of the contact. So from this, I'm going to go ahead and click save. Now we've successfully added a new custom field into our CRM system. So we're going to go back, look at contacts and choose Dean again. And we scroll down here under additional information. And now we see there's actually an anniversary date. We can just simply pick this. And now we can add as much information about a contact that we want for as many fields as you like. There are unlimited number of fields. So that's a really great feature of Highlevel to be able to do that. Now, this right here is, again, some of the very basics of the CRM system. But basically, it's kind of like a big contacts area on steroids. So you can put as much information as you want in here, store as many records as you want. There's an unlimited number of contact fields. And all of the information in here, again, is the hub. All the other features that we use pull data from the CRM system. So here's one of the key benefits of Highlevel has that other systems don't. So most people use a third-party CRM system. I know at one point I was using, for instance, ActiveCampaign to do a lot of my email marketing campaigns and some of my workflows. Well, my CRM system was actually in a separate system. It wasn't in ActiveCampaign. So I constantly had to update that via third parties. And I'm talking about Zaps here. If you've ever run Zapier, I'm going to show you that here in just a minute, but I actually had to run a Zap to actually communicate between those two systems. The nice thing about Highlevel is there is no, and the integration is built in. As soon as the contact is added, there's no need to update them in another system. The email campaign can pull directly from that particular person, and all the other features of Highlevel immediately has access to that contact record. So one of the other nice things about it, and I'm not going to go into, this isn't going to be a video over Zapier, but I just wanted to show you that inside of Zapier, the connector is called lead connector. So that's what you would be looking for inside of Zapier that will connect to Highlevel. So those are all the main connection points. It is a built-in connector inside of Zapier. So you can pull data from, send data to Highlevel. They do have an open API for that. So anyway, that is the basics of the CRM system. I hope you found it useful. And again, thank you so much and have a great day. Hey, I want to thank you again for visiting my channel and give you one more little thing here. If you are interested in Highlevel and getting some additional Highlevel training, please see the link in the description below. I do have a free course I'm offering that covers everything related to Highlevel and gives you all the information that you need to know. Thank you so much and have a great day.